Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Dick Martin, from Chips, Breanne Lurie, Bill Daly, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Reeder.
Goodbye, Gene. That's right. Everybody all set over here?
Yeah. All right, guys.
One big star here, Carolyn Haisner, with $22,100. This girl is rich. How's it feel to be rich?
Oh.
That's what everybody says. Oh. What are you going to do with all that loot?
Buy Pacoima.
You don't know? She's going to buy Pacoima?
Buy Texas. No, I don't. I want to get some new carpet for my house.
Okay, that's $1,000. Now you got $21,000 to go. Bucks. What else?
I want to buy something for my dad.
Oh. What do you want, Dad? What do you want?
A new car.
How about some carpet, Dad?
Yeah, we got a few yards of carpet left over. You want some of that? Gonna build a room. Oh, that's sweet.
What about something for the panel?
Can I live?
Yeah, what about something for the panel?
If she comes to me for carpet, Gene, I have a fine selection of odd lots and remnants out there.
Odd lots and remnants, eh? Okay, let's see if she's gonna win more money here. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. 17 blank. Now remember, 500 for the most popular. 250 for the second most. 100 for the third. Three of the six stars will assist.
Miss Fanny.
Well.
Miss Fanny, how did
you say? Miss Fanny. History means nothing to me. However, a date sticks in my mind. 1776.
Okay.
Miss Brett.
Was that a movie called 17th Summer?
No.
Summer of the 17th.
Summer of the 17th.
There was a Broadway show. 17 by Booth Tarkington.
Yeah, just 17. Nothing. Don't fill in the blank.
How about...
You got anything?
I don't know if I'm going to get called on. I don't want to give it to you. Are you going to call on me? Otherwise, I'll give it to her.
Oh, I got it. 17 Magazine.
17 Mag.
No.
Okay. One more.
You call me, I'll kill you.
I think there's only one, and she already has it.
It's what they give when the president of Poland comes, a 17-gun salute.
All right, you had 17 magazines?
I had 17 magazines.
Oh, and she gave it to...
17, yes.
All right, no, 17-gun salute. That's your answer. Yeah, they may come up.
Don't.
No, listen, we get weird people in this audience sometimes. You never know. They might have said that.
People
would you say that?
Us.
Sure you would. Yeah.
Oh, please turn off the fan, Lord.
Here we go. Are you cold?
I'm frozen to death.
All right. Turn off the fan. Then we'll get too hot.
These are
okay. All right. You got 1776, 17 Magazine, and 17 Gun Salute. Those are the three. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'm going to go with Fanny on 1776.
Okay. That's it. Find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 number. 17 Magazine is Brett's answer. Okay. Let's see what we've got under the $250 response. 17 and over. What does that mean?
That's to get a drink.
No,
well, that's the age you get a drink in some states.
27 and over.
Yeah.
No, that's X-rated movies you can get into.
17 and over, X-rated movies.
Yeah,
I see.
You can get in to see The Devil and Mrs. Rayburn if you're 17 and over.
Okay, last chance. Here we go for the $500 number. Yeah! $22,600. We'll see if she's going to double that. See what she's playing for here. Right after we do a little business with America. Go! Get him, Bill! That's the way to go, Bill! Here we go. This gal has won the $500. She now has $22,600. And she's going to play for at least $5,000 and maybe $10,000. Good luck to you, Carolyn. We're all going to root for a double for you. Here we go. Bing. Any of the gold stars will be a double. Summers, are you ready?
Oh, yeah, she's ready. I don't know. I'm going to do my best.
You're playing for $10,000.
$10,000, Brett.
$10,000. Oh, I hate that. Brett. Why would I ever be friendly with Fanny?
Oh, you're very close to her. $22,750 is the most anybody's ever won. You got this moment at $22,600. I point out to you that CBS has a limitation of $25,000. However, if you win the $10,000 now, you get the chance to keep it all, okay? Here we go. Here we go. Snug blank. S-N-U-G blank. Snug blank. Okay, she's finished. Now, Carolyn, ring the dinger. If you give us the answer that she's got on the card, you get $10,000 additional for a total of $32,600. What have you got for us here?
Snug is a bug in a rug.
Snug is a bug in a rug. Okay. Now, before we ask Brett to show us a card, I have to review a rule here for you. On this part of it, it has to be an exact match. Okay. Snug as a bug in a rug is what she said.
I have snug as a bug. I don't have in a rug.
You're not getting it.
Yes. Now, this is as far as you can go. You've won all the money that you can possibly win here. So we'll just ask you to gracefully make an exit. Follow that tall, skinny fellow in the blue suit over there. That's our producer, Iris Kutch. And we thank you. That we've had to introduce two players at one time, and we've never had that big a money winner. This is a historic day on this show, $32,600. We welcome both of you. I'd like to find out a little bit about you. We'll begin with you, sir. Tell us where you're from and all that.
I'm from Seattle, Washington.
Yep.
And we're down here on vacation. I'm married. We're a parts manager for a diesel engine firm in Seattle, and we deal with the commercial fishermen in Western Washington and all of Alaska.
You live in a beautiful part of the country.
Yes, sir. We enjoy it.
Okay.
It's a little wet, but it's nice.
But things grow. How are your ferns?
My ferns?
Yes.
My ferns are doing pretty good under grow lights.
Yeah. Everybody in the block is talking about his fern fronds. Yes, and kind of the moisture up there.
Mine died.
All right. Yours died. I'm sorry to hear that. Okay, Ron, now we'll find out about Essie.
Well, I'm a makeup artist. I live here in Los Angeles, and I do nail painting. Got my Grouchos on.
What? Wait a minute. That's Mark Breslow, what does that say there?
It's Groucho.
Groucho Marx on every fingernail.
He's my favorite.
Look
I
at
love
that.
Him.
Wait a minute. There's
you mean on every
can you see that?
It says Groucho Marx.
No, it's his face.
It's his face. Is it okay the now? Face? Can you see it, Johnny? That's Groucho Marx.
Got it.
You do your own.
Yeah.
I see.
Wow. Say the sacred word, the
okay.
rubber comes down.
Have you ever made me up?
Not yet. I hope to.
All right. You're hired.
Thank you.
Now, we'll play this game first, right after we do a little business with America. Here we go. Now, since we have never had this situation before, usually when we get two new people out here, or at the very beginning, We always flip a coin to see which of our contestants will go first. We're going to do that right. No, we can't flip Brett. We're going to do that right here now. Now, who calls it, Ira? All right. Which one wants to call it?
Heads.
You're going to call heads.
Heads.
Okay. I'll let it fall right here on the desk, and there
it's
it is.
It's a double-headed coin. Oh,
does that count?
Yeah.
That counts. Okay. Well, you better look at it there just to make sure that it is what it is. What is it?
Tails.
Tails.
Ooh.
That's you, right? So that means you will go first, right? Is that what that means,
Ira?
I'll
give the 50 cents.
Okay. There you are.
Ira's got to have it.
Okay. Oh, sorry about that. Now, we'll push the button here. And, Ron, you can have A or B.
I'll take B.
B. Okay. Robbie the robot said,
"Oh, I hate being made out of old vending machine parts. Every time someone shakes my hand, I have an uncontrollable urge to give him blank."
I hate being made out of old vending machine parts. Every time someone shakes my hand, I have an uncontrollable urge to give him blank. Right. Good one. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. I haven't got one.
Oh. I am so embarrassed sitting next to this guy.
Shrimp balls ever come in.
I hate being made out of old vending machine parts. Those are the key words.
Yeah.
Vending machine part. Every time someone shakes my hand. Okay. Yes. Robbie the robot said,
"I hate being made out of old vending machine parts. Every time someone shakes my hand, I have an uncontrollable urge to give him
a cigarette.
Pack of cigarettes. Okay. What? Oh, it's Ron's. Oh. I'm so used to doing it the other way. All right, now wait a minute. Let's have a meeting. Let's have a meeting here and decide what we're going to do about this. I made a mistake. For the first time in 6 years, I made a mistake. All right, let's see. Have you had enough time to think it over? Oh, go to another question. Throw those away.
I had a great answer.
Had a good answer?
Yes.
All right, now throw them away. Now, Ron, do you want A or B now?
Thanks a lot. I'll take A.
What? Go to commercial. Panic! Spin it, commercial! Panic! Medic! Doctor! We'll pretend that never happened. Okay, Ron?
Okay.
Starting all over. Now, you're going to have A or B. We're going to start with you, and we're going to end with you.
B.
And you stay out of it, all right?
April!
While looking in a microscope, one scientist said to the other, "This is a weird centipede. He doesn't have 100 legs. He has 99 legs and a blank." That's what it says.
Is it a male or a female centipede?
Doesn't make any difference.
It makes a lot of difference to me.
No, it doesn't.
It makes a lot of difference to the centipede.
No. It's a weird centipede. Doesn't have 100 legs. He has 99 legs and a blank. I don't know if there are males and females. I'm not familiar with
centipedes.
No, any centipedes.
Entomology is an organized study of the origin of words and
centipede.
Yes, it has to do with
insects.
Okay, right. While looking at a microscope, one scientist said to another, "This is a weird centipede. He doesn't have 100 legs. He has 99 legs and a
arm."
All right, that's okay. Now, what was so hard about that?
My
I ask you.
You want to picture something bizarre?
Yeah.
Midnight in an orthopedic supply store. My centipede had 99 legs and a cane.
Aha! Made an interesting sound when he walked. Hello.
Hello, darling. It's so nice to see you.
Thank you.
My centipede had 99 legs and a mother at his side.
And a mother at his side. Okay.
My centipede had 99 legs and another centipede.
And another centipede.
Just to keep company.
C'est ridicule.
This centipede doesn't have 100 legs. He has 99 legs and a...
mouth!
And a mouth.
And I'm so sorry.
All right. Go,
don't
Bill.
You boo that girl. Please she's taking don't. Enough this week.
You got a good one, Bill?
This is my crowd, right? An arm?
Yeah. You know how to woo an audience, don't
yes.
you?
Woo audience.
Woo! Woo.
Can I use his answer?
Yes.
No, you have to do your own there.
I said he had 99 legs and a crutch.
Mm-hmm. And a crutch.
Yeah.
Well, that's logical. Okay, so you pick up one on that run.
He would have a bad
now let's
run.
See what we have for Essie. Here it is. The caddy said.
The woohoo.
The caddy.
Oh, as in golf.
As in golf,
no,
yes. No wonder that golfer can't get the ball in the cup. Instead of a golf ball, he's using a blink. He can't get it in the cup. Instead of a golf ball, he's using, or a hole, or whatever you want to call that thing in the middle of the green grass.
Now, wait a minute, this is a sport question, and you know I don't do well on
instead
those.
Instead of a golf ball, he's using a
the
blank.
The caddy said, no one of the golfer can't get the ball in the cup. Instead of in the cup. Oh,
yeah, right.
Well, you know, that changes it, doesn't
right.
it?
If you need any clarification, Dick is a golfer. He'll tell you. Okay, Essie, are you ready? Here we go. The caddy said, no wonder that golfer can't get the ball in the cup. Instead of a golf ball, he's using a...
basketball.
Basketball would be impossible to get it in the cup, wouldn't it? She said a basketball, which is certainly...
it would be hard to get
you know,
into
very
it.
Very difficult.
You get bigger bees yeah. into a little... Ah, well, mine is awful messy. You spend hours picking up the seeds of watermelon.
Watermelon? That'd be difficult. Yes.
You could get him into Fanny's cup, I'll bet. Bowling ball.
A bowling ball. Leave that girl alone there.
Hi. A football.
A football would be very difficult. Funny bouncing ball there.
You paint a graphic image.
Essie is looking for a basketball, Brianne.
Well, I am very depressed because Brett and I obviously have the same vibes. Bowling ball.
Bowling ball, there. A little basketball for the lady, please.
A foot basketball.
A foot basketball.
No, that's wrong.
Nice try.
A football?
Fanny, give her a basketball.
Now. I'd love to, but you know, I was trying to be correct, and I was trying to think of a white ball, and I thought of a volleyball.
A volleyball.
It's white, isn't it?
It's white. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, they're off-white anyway.
Wrong balls there.
Okay, so there it is. One and nothing at the end of round one. We go to round two. And start with him.
Start with him.
Why?
The man.
Oh, that's right. We started with him. Oh, yeah, we reversed the whole thing. We have to keep doing this, huh? Let's just spin it around and get rid of these two. I'm tired of this thing. Okay, Ron, who do you want, A or B here?
A.
A. Okay. Lois Lane said...
oh, yeah, Superman, good. Superman!
No, she said, this weather is really terrible. It's so cold, Superman froze his blank off.
His what?
His weather.
His blank.
This weather is really terrible.
I love you, Superman.
So cold, Superman froze his blank off.
He's freezing. You can read my mind.
Go on.
I'll be calling
you. Okay, over there. Here we go, Ron. Lois Lane said, this weather is really terrible. It's so cold, Superman froze his blank off.
Derriere?
Derriere?
Oh, you mean buns? Is that what you're trying to say, buns?
He said derriere. Okay. Orson?
So cute, though.
That's what they call it up there. Froze his kryptonite off.
His kryptonite. His kryptonite. Okay.
Now, it's all according to how you're thinking, whether or not this is a match. His ass.
His ass. You know, on the chest. What do you got there?
His derriere.
Derriere. Okay. All right, 3M, go.
He is just so cute that I said cape.
His cape. And Fanny.
I am so sorry.
I want you, the judges, to listen very carefully because this is a Southern pronunciation. Ayes.
All right. 2-0 to score. Now we've got this for you. Pay attention. 25 seconds. What would you like to do? 25 seconds.
What are you playing? We can do a whole thing.
My mom will sell the costumes.
All right, what do you do? She can paint the scenery.
I'd like to say a few words about Proposition 13.
Ladies and gentlemen, no, it's all over.
Don't get that started on.
Join us next time for Match Game 79. Goodbye.
Welcome to the warm blanket of love that is George Gray.
Get out.
Got brain?
Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
New half hours of The Weakest Link, hosted by George Gray. Feel the love, coming up next on GSN.
GSN.
This is as far as you can go. You've won all the money that you can possibly win here. So we'll just ask you to gracefully make an exit. Follow that tall, skinny fellow in the blue suit over there. That's our producer, Iris Kutch. And we thank you. That we've had to introduce two players at one time, and we've never had that big a money winner. This is a historic day on this show, $32,600. We welcome both of you. I'd like to find out a little bit about you. We'll begin with you, sir. Tell us where you're from and all that.
I'm from Seattle, Washington.
Yep.
And we're down here on vacation. I'm married. We're a parts manager for a diesel engine firm in Seattle, and we deal with the commercial fishermen in Western Washington and all of Alaska.
You live in a beautiful part of the country.
Yes, sir. We enjoy it.
Okay.
It's a little wet, but it's nice.
But things grow. How are your ferns?
My ferns?
Yes.
My ferns are doing pretty good under the grow lights.
Yeah. Everybody in the block is talking about his fern fronds. Yes, I'm kind of the moisture up there.
Mine died.
All right. Yours died. I'm sorry to hear that. Okay, Ron, now we'll find out about Essie.
Well, I'm a makeup artist. I live here in Los Angeles, and I do nail painting. Got my Grouchos on.
What? Wait a minute. That's Mark Breslow, what does that say there?
It's Groucho.
Groucho Marx on every fingernail.
He's my favorite.
Look
I
at
love
that.
Him.
Wait a minute. There's
you mean on every
can you see that?
It says Groucho Marx.
No, it's his face.
It's his face. Is it okay now? Can you see it, Johnny?
Get ready to match the stars. Orson V. Brett Summers, Dick Martin, from Chips, Breanne Lurie, Bill Daly, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Reagor.
That's right. Everybody all set over here?
Yeah.
All right, guys. Want to meet the star here, Carolyn Haisner, with $22,100. Come on out here. This girl is rich. How does it feel to be rich?
Oh.
That's what everybody says. Oh. What are you going to do with all that loot?
Buy Pacoima.
You don't know? She's going to buy Pacoima?
Texas. No, I don't. I want to get some new carpet for my house.
Okay, that's $1,000. Now you got $21,000 to go. What else?
I want to buy something for my dad.
Oh. What do you want, Dad? What do you want?
A car.
How about some carpet, Dad?
Hey, we got a few yards of carpet left over. You want some of that? Gonna build a room. Oh, that's sweet.
What about something for the panel?
Can I live
Yeah, what about something for the panel?
If she comes to me for carpet, Jane, I have a fine selection of odd lots and remnants out there.
Odd lots and remnants, eh? Okay, let's see if she's gonna win more money here. We pulled the studio.
I'm gonna go with Fanny on 1776.
Okay. That's it. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. 17 Magazine is Brett's answer. Okay, let's see what we've got under the $250 response. 17 and over. What does that mean?
That's to get a drink.
Well, that's the age you get a drink in some states.
27 and over.
Yeah.
No, that's X-rated movies you can get into.
17 and over, X-rated movies.
Yeah, you can get in to see The Devil and Mrs. Rayburn if you're 17 and over.
Okay, last chance. Here we go for the $500 number. Yeah! $22,600. We'll see if she's going to double that. See how much she's playing for here. Right after we do a little business with America. Go! Get him, Bill! That way to go, Bill. Here we go. This gal has won the $500. She now has $22,600. And she's going to play for at least $5,000 and maybe $10,000. Good luck to you, Carolyn. We're all going to root for a double for you. Here we go. Bing. Any of the gold stars will be a double. Summers, are you ready?
Oh, yeah, she's ready. I don't know.
Now,
I didn't do my best.
You're playing for $10,000.
$10,000, Brett.
$10,000. Why would I ever be?
The audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. 17 blank. Now remember, 500 for the most popular, 250 for the second most, 100 for the third. Three of the six stars will assist.
Miss Fanny.
Well,
Miss Fanny, honey,
Miss Fanny, history means nothing to me. However, a date sticks in my mind. 1776.
Okay.
Miss Brett.
Was that a movie called 17th Summer?
No.
Summer of the 17th.
Summer of the 17th. Oh, okay.
The West Coast Broadway called show. 17 by Booth Tarkington.
Yeah, just 17. Nothing. Don't fill in the blank.
How about...
Got anything? I don't know if I'm going to get called on. I don't want to give it to you. Are you going to call on me? Otherwise, I'll give it to her.
Oh, I got it. 17 Magazine.
17 Mag.
No.
Okay. One more.
You're calling me. I'll show you.
I think there's only one, and she
Orson.
Already has it.
Sorry.
It's what they give when the president of Poland comes, a 17-gun salute.
All right, you had 17 magazines?
I had 17 magazines.
Oh, and she gave
17,
it to
17, yes.
All right, no, 17-gun salute. That's your answer.
Yeah, that's
hey,
good.
Mate, come on.
Don't.
No, listen, we get weird people in this audience right. sometimes. You never know. They might have said that.
People
would you say that?
Us.
Sure you would. Yeah.
Oh, please turn
All right.
off the fan, Lord.
Here we go. Are you cold?
I'm frozen to death.
All right, turn off the fan. Then we'll get too hot.
These are
okay.
Our
All right, you got 1776, 17 Magazine, and 17 Gun Salute. Those are the three. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. Oh, you're very close to the... 22,750 is the most anybody's ever won. You got this moment have 22,600. I point out to you that CBS has a limitation of $25,000. However, if you win the $10,000 now, you get the chance to keep it all, okay? Here we go. Here we go. Snug blank. S-N-U-G blank. Snug blank. Okay, she's finished. Now, Carolyn, ring the dinger. If you give us the answer that she's got on the card, you get $10,000 additional for a total of $32,600. What have you got for us here?
Snug as a bug in a rug.
Snug as a bug in a rug. Okay. Now, before we ask Brett to show us the card, I have to review a rule here for you. On this part of it, it has to be an exact match. Okay. Snug as a bug in a rug is what she said.
I have snug as a bug. I don't have in a
give
rug.
It. Yeah, give it.
Here You have extra room on the house and do all of those things. Yes. Now.